Hi, I'm Shauna from Pulse Cardiac Health, and this is our full body strength and stretch class using a tubing. So we're going to work every major muscle group in your body. We're going to do a strength exercise for it, as well as a little bit of a stretch. So we're going to do about 15 or 20 minutes of standing exercise, and then we're going to grab a mat and we're going to get down on the floor for the last 15 minutes or so. If you only feel comfortable doing the standing portion, then that's absolutely fine. Just stop it at that point. So you should feel pretty good at this point. This is a very common class for those of you that have completed cardiac rehabilitation and are feeling pretty comfortable with your exercise tolerance. You should be at least 12 weeks post open heart surgery. So that chest should feel pretty good. It may not feel quite normal just yet. You may still have a few aches and pains, but overall it feels okay. You've got pretty much full range of motion in that chest and have been doing a little bit of activity to this point. As always, with all of our classes, make sure you're monitoring how you feel. Go through the exercise slowly, take your time, and I don't want you to feel any sort of pain or negative sensation at all, okay? So really kind of monitor how you're feeling and make sure you go nice and slow. So with that being said, all you need to get is a tubing, and then find a place to be, and we'll go ahead and get started. All right, so let's go ahead and get started. I've just put my tubing down on the ground just so we can do a little bit of a warm up to get started. So just roll those shoulders nice and big just to start with. And then let's roll them the other way. We'll start to kind of shake off any sitting we've been doing today. All right, and we're gonna take a big deep breath, breathe in and breathe out. And again, one more time, breathe in. And stay up here and let your air out as you tilt to the side, just nice and gentle. And then up and over to the other side. Good, and up and over. We're not holding any stretches for very long. We're just doing some nice little warm up here. Good, and let that down. And now we're just gonna pick up those feet, okay? Slow little march, bringing those knees up as high as you can, just to warm up those legs a little as well. Get out any of the cracks and pops that tend to happen in those hips. Good, and we're gonna go side and open. Oh, stepping on my tubing. Good. Kind of a jumping jack version here. Just getting warmed up. Two more, last one, good. And now stick your heel into the floor and just kind of lean forward a little bit. Heel into the floor and lean forward. You might feel a stretch down the back side of your thighs. Don't go very far, take your time. And those arms are just kind of swaying along the side. Good. Just a couple more and we'll go ahead and we'll get into it a little. Last one. Okay, go ahead and grab your tubing. And what we're gonna do to start with is we're gonna stand on our tube. So hanging on to those handles, we're gonna start with some squats. So there's a couple of options here. You can stand just how you are with the tubing next to your side, okay? Or if you want extra challenge, you can bring that tubing on up to your shoulders and rest it here. So I'll demonstrate this one, but if you don't feel comfortable doing this, keep that tubing down at your side. And then all you're gonna do with your weight in your heels, you're gonna stick that bum out behind you and squat down. Again, we're gonna get out some of those cracks and pops. Trying to keep your chest fairly lifted. Only go down as far as your body feels comfortable to. Shooting that bum out behind you. Squeezing those bum muscles as you stand up. Weight in your heels. And only two more and we're done with this one. Last one. Good, all right, step out of that band. Open up those legs, big and wide, and we'll just bend to one side. So the one leg is straight and the leg is bent, and we're just stretching that inner thigh just a little bit. Take a nice breath. Good, and then up and over, other side. Stretching that inner thigh. That's good. All right, bringing those legs back together. We're gonna put the tubing behind our back and under our arms. Let go of those handles and grab onto the band part to cinch it up nice and tight. And we're gonna do our chest press. So our feet should be about hip width apart. Bend those knees a little bit, pull in your tummy, and then punch those arms. And just punching forward, make sure you're breathing. So this exercise is gonna work that chest a little bit, those chest muscles. That's it, you can hear my handles banging around. Good, we're gonna do three more. Two, last one, good. Now we're gonna grab that tubing and we're gonna lift it up and over your head, grabbing onto it about kind of a little wider than shoulder height. And then from here, same thing, setting your foundation, feet are nice and hip width apart, knees bent, open that tubing up and pull it to your chest, squeezing those shoulder blades, and then release. Open and squeeze, and then release. I'll stand sideways so you can see me. You can see that when I open and squeeze, I'm not letting my back arch out, keeping my back nice and flat, pinching a pencil, that's it. Four, three, two, and one. Nicely done. All right, just reach forward, stretch that out, round your upper back, and then we'll rotate to one side. And rotate to the other. And again, we'll reach to the ceiling, take a big deep breath, and blow it out. Good. Put your hands behind your back, squeezing your shoulder blades together, opening that chest up and look up. Again, keep your belly pulled in and just opening across that chest. Okay, for those of you that have had open heart, see how this feels. Don't push too hard. All right, rolling those shoulders again. Okay, bicep curls are next. So stand on that tube, grabbing onto your handles. Elbows are tucked in beside you. Knees bent to release that low back a little bit. Pull your belly in and then curl up. If you only feel comfortable doing one arm at a time, you're welcome to do that. Otherwise, both. Okay, working on those bicep muscles, which are the muscles right at the front of your arm here, right here. Good job. Four more. Three. Two. And one. Good. Drop one handle. Let that band lengthen out underneath your foot just a little bit. And then bring that tubing in behind your arm. Standing nice and strong, and we're gonna punch to the sky. Working on those shoulders. If you've got bad shoulders and this doesn't feel very good, then stay within that range of motion that feels okay, or you can do it without the band and just use your arm, okay, as your own weight. That's an option for you. Four more. Keep going, make sure you're breathing. Last one, and then we're gonna stay with that same arm, put your arm out to the side, palm down, knuckles up, and lift to shoulder height. Good job. I just need to tighten my band up a little bit so you can stand closer to that handle to do that. That's it, staying nice and strong in your belly so that you're not using your body to assist you here. We're staying nice and still. Last one, and we're gonna switch the other side. Good, okay, switch. So put the handle in the other hand. in behind that arm, and again, punch. That's it, staying nice and strong in your core. Knees are bent a little bit. Make sure you're not holding your breath. Breathe, it's important. Two more, last one. Good, palm down, knuckles up, out to the side, to shoulder height. Again, making sure you're staying nice and strong in your body. You're not tilting your body to do this. Keep working. That's it, four more. Three, two, and one. Nicely done. Bring that arm across your body and we'll do a quick stretch. So your other arm is just grabbing onto that elbow and you're almost trying to give yourself a bit of a headlock. Holding that nice and tight. Take a breath. Good, and we'll switch to the other side. Bring that arm across your body. Grab on. Good job. All right, the next is our triceps, which is the muscle in the back of our arms here. So what you're gonna do with that is you're gonna fold that tubing in half. Okay, you're gonna grab on to the top of the tube and put this hand on your opposite shoulder. Okay, and then this arm is gonna grab partway down that band and you're gonna have that elbow tucked into your side and your arm is at about 90 degrees, okay? So this is your anchor up here and the one down here is gonna do the work and all you're gonna do is pull down. So you're pulling that arm down so that it's in line with your hip, okay? And the one at the top is just resisting and holding that band still for you. This one can get a little confusing. I find with our maintenance group that Monday mornings, people's arms get crisscrossed a little bit with this exercise, mine as well. Good job. Two more and we'll switch sides. Good, now switch. So the other hand's gonna come to the top, opposite shoulder. Elbow comes into your side, grab onto that band about halfway down and pull. Now there is the option if you want to just grab one band. That'll make it a little bit easier than grabbing both. Okay, so that's an option for you. Keep breathing. Hear my handles rattling around down there. Two more, last one, good work. Okay, palm up, flip it over top, elbow towards the ceiling and we'll get a nice stretch on that tricep muscle. Good, keep holding, keep breathing. And we'll switch, other side. That's it, how are you doing, okay? Stop and rest if you need to. I'm sure you're doing great though. Okay, so the next ones are deadlifts. I know that name sounds kind of scary, but it's not that scary. You're gonna grab, put stand on that tube. Feet are hip width apart. Let go of the handles. Reach down and grab onto the tube part nice and low and then pull that strong, okay? Now, just standing here, your knees should have a soft bend. Your back is straight, your shoulders are back, and then all you're doing is hinging at your hips and leaning forward. Shooting that bum out behind you, your back stays flat, your arms are just going along for the ride, and then you're squeezing your bum muscles to stand back up. So you're just hinging forward, squeeze those bum muscles to stand back up. So this is all the work is coming from your backside, okay? When you hinge forward, you might feel a little bit of a stretch down the backside of your legs, and that's okay. Shouldn't feel pain. Squeeze those bum muscles to stand up. Now, the more tension you have on that band, the more work your body has to do. So you adjust based on how you feel. That's it, keeping your shoulders back. Your back is flat. Two more. And last one. Good, let go of that tube and then step out so it doesn't snap you. Now the next one is our lunges. So you're welcome to be near the wall for a little bit of balance support if you need to. We're gonna put one foot in front of the other, okay? And then we're just gonna drop that back knee down towards the floor and press up through that front heel. If you don't need that wall support, that's okay. So the weight is in your front leg. And only go down as low as you feel comfortable. Try not to lean forward over that front leg. Trying to stay upright as much as you can, like you're going up and down in an elevator from the top of your head. That's it, two more. Last one, and we're gonna switch to the other side. One foot in front of the other, back knee down, press up. That's it. Press through that heel of the front foot. Take your time. Four, three, two, and one. Good. Okay, using that wall for balance again, you're gonna grab onto your foot. Okay, so you can use your shoe, your pant leg, whatever you can, and grab onto that foot. You're squeezing that bum muscle and trying to get that knee of this leg to point down towards the floor. And just take a breath. You should feel that stretched on the front side of your leg. Good. And switch legs. If you want, you can work on your balance here and do it without holding onto the wall. And just have that wall near you if you need it. Nice breath. Those lunges always get me breathing. Good. Okay, staying near that wall. Come up onto your toes for some calf raises. Lifting up as high as you can, getting those heels right off the floor, up and over the balls of your feet. Again, if you want to work on your balance, let go of the wall. Know that it's near you. Balance is always a good thing to work on, even just a little bit. Definitely starts to go as we start to get a little older. Our risks of falls increase. So working on our balance is a good thing. Okay, so we're gonna do just that. What I want you to do is stand with one foot directly in front of the other. So your foot is heel to toe, okay? Now, you can have your arms out to the side to add a little bit of balance support. You can be near that wall for some balance support. If you're wobbling a little, that's okay. We're trying to work on that balance. Find a spot that isn't moving and just look at that spot and focus on that balance. If you need extra, if you've got this and it feels pretty solid, you need extra work, you can come up onto your toes for a couple more calf raises while you're in that position. That's it. And now let's switch. Let's put the other foot in front, heel to toe. So your heel is touching your toe. Get that balance sorted. You've got that wall if you need it. And again, if you want extra challenge, up onto your toes. That's it. Okay, so we're gonna stretch that out now. So facing the wall, one foot in front of the other, big giant step. That back heel is pressing into the ground, and bend your front knee, leaning towards the wall. And you should feel that stretch down the back side of your thigh. Take a nice breath here. And switch, other side. Pressing that back heel into the floor. Bend your front knee. Good job, just hold. All right, we're gonna do our wall push-ups now. So I'm just gonna let my band down. Your hands are about shoulder height, shoulder width. The further you walk your feet out behind you, the more challenge you're gonna be. So if you're just starting, you might wanna be up here, okay? So just depending on how you feel, you're gonna keep your body nice and straight, and you're gonna lower your chest in towards the wall and push yourself away. You don't really want those elbows to wing out too much. You wanna try and keep them down towards you a little bit more. Keeping your body nice and strong in one straight line. Your heels are gonna lift off the floor, and that's okay. Coming onto your toes. Four, three, two, and one. Good. All right, so that's it for our standing work. So we'll take a quick break while you grab a mat, and we'll be right back. Okay, so now that we're down on our mats, all I want you to do is take your tubing and put it around one foot. Lay back onto your back and bring that foot up to the sky. The opposite leg is going to lengthen out along the floor. And that leg on the floor is actively pressing into the ground. The leg in the sky, you've got enough tension on that tube that it can feel pretty supported up there. You're getting a nice stretch on the back of your thigh. You might even get it into your back of your knee or all the way up to your ankle, just depending on how tight you are. Again, this shouldn't hurt. You should just feel that there's a nice stretch there, and take a couple of breaths. Good. Now we're gonna let that leg fall out to the side, and we're stretching out that inner thigh, anchoring yourself down with that opposite leg. Taking a couple breaths here. And then bring that leg up and over to the other side, stretching the outer side of your thigh, maybe up into your hip. Again, you don't want it to hurt, just feel a nice stretch. Good, and then back up, switch feet, however you feel comfortable doing that. And again, this opposite leg is pressing into the ground, it's active. The one in the sky, you're trying to relax as much as you can. Do your best to straighten out your knee. You can play with your toe position a little bit. Just make sure that the tubing doesn't slide over the front of your shoe. Otherwise, it'll snap you, and we don't want that. Giving yourself some breaths here. And then again, letting that leg fall out to the side. I can't go quite as far, so I'm gonna hit the back wall here. And up and over, other side, cross your body. Good, okay, we're gonna let that go. And we're gonna get into some abdominals here. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna bring those shins up parallel to the floor, and your hands are gonna go up towards the sky. You wanna pull your belly in, and that low back stays connected to the mat. And then you're gonna go opposite arm, opposite leg,
and pull back to center, and then switch opposite arm, opposite leg. The key is that you're breathing and that low back stays connected to the floor. If your low back is lifting or you find this too hard, keep your knees bent and just heel tap to the floor. So you're just gonna do this instead of extending that leg out straight. It'll just make it a little bit easier for you, not quite as heavy of a load to have to bear. So you're really using that low back as your guide. We're gonna do four more. Three, two, last one. Good, take a little rest. All right, bring those feet back up to the sky. Your arms are open wide, and we're gonna do our crisscrosses. So you're opening up those legs, cross one foot in front of the other, open up, other foot goes in front. Again, that belly is staying down towards the floor, and your low back is connected to the mat, and we're breathing. Five, four, three, two, and one. Take a rest. Good. Now, if you need to rest before I do, go ahead and do that. Don't feel you have to hold up if you can't. Okay, make sure you're breathing. And again, last time, we're gonna bring those feet up again. And this time we're gonna do our cycling. So we're gonna pedal those feet, riding our imaginary bikes. The further your legs are away from you, the harder it is. The further they are up towards the ceiling, the easier it is. So you adjust, and then we're gonna pedal the other way. Biking along, gotta go back to where we came from here. Keep pedaling. Five, four, three, two, and one, rest. Stretch that out, arms out, legs out. Big giant stretch. Good, now we're gonna bring those feet back underneath us for glute bridges. So you can take your band if you want, and you can anchor it down over top of your hips to add extra work. Otherwise, don't worry about it. We're pressing through those heels and lifting your hips up off the floor, squeezing those bum muscles, and then lowering back down nice and slow. Make sure you take your time. Your knees are staying parallel to each other. There should be about two fist widths between those legs. And you're pressing up as high as you can. Squeezing those bum muscles. Really think about those bum muscles and give them a good squeeze to get those hips up. All right, last three, two. Now this last one, I want you to lift and hold. Stay up here, hold, and I want you to open and close those knees. Open and close. Five, four, keep those hips up. Three, two, and one. Good job, lower down. Bring those knees in towards your chest. Give yourself a good squish. You can rock from side to side. Release that low back. Whatever feels good for you. Good, now your feet are gonna come to the floor. Arms are gonna open wide. Those knees stay together and just fall to one side. Keeping your shoulders on the mat. And if your neck feels okay with it, turn your head in the opposite direction of your legs. And just breathe. If you have osteoporosis of your spine, we don't want you to do this one. We don't want you to do the twisting. Good, and now we're gonna bring those knees up and we're gonna let them fall the other way. And again, turn your head in the opposite direction of your legs and just take a nice breath here. Good, and back up. All right, keeping those feet flat on the floor, that low back is connected to the mat. I want you to take those arms and have your hands facing the ceiling and your elbows at or about shoulder height, okay? Now from here, all I want you to do is let those hands fall towards the floor Now you're trying to keep your wrist in line and everything like a straight board. Good, and just hold. Some of you may not be able to reach, some of you are gonna be about here. Just working on that shoulder mobility a little bit. And now from here, I want you to let those arms slide up the floor and then slide back. Trying to keep those forearms on the ground. And if you're not quite on the ground, that's okay. You're just letting those elbows slide up and slide back. Again, it shouldn't hurt. Back off if it hurts. Just a couple more, keeping that belly tucked in, low back connected to the floor. All right, that's enough of that. Good job. Okay, roll on to your side and we're gonna do our clamshells. So your hips, knees, and feet are all stacked. You're welcome to take your band and wrap it around your legs if you like. Don't feel like you have to do this. Your hips, knees, and feet are all stacked like you're in one long line and then you're opening up that top knee, okay? If you weren't using your band, it just looks like this, okay? You can also have your feet lifted and that adds extra work as well. You can have your hand on the outside of your thigh to give yourself extra work. So lots of options here depending on how strong you feel. Good, trying not to roll back, keeping everything in line. Good, now we're gonna straighten out that top leg and we're gonna lift for 10. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Now hold that leg out there parallel to the floor and we're gonna draw circles with that leg. You should feel your hip right out here working a little. Good, and now we're gonna circle the other way. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, enough of that. Flip over. We'll do the same thing on the other side. Okay, so hips, knees, and feet all stacked, and whatever version you took on the first side, if you had your feet lifted, if you had your hand over your thigh, or if you were using your band, I want you to do the same thing on the second side so that we stay balanced. And you're not rolling back, and you're not rolling forward. You're staying right in line. Two more, last one. Good, straighten out that top leg and lift. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Hold that leg there and draw circles. Good job. And circle the other way. That's it. 4, 3, 2, 1. Nicely done. Roll onto your back. Okay, from here, with your knees bent, take one ankle and cross it over mid-thigh of your opposite leg. With the knee that's winging out here, I want you to grab onto it and pull it in towards your chest. You might feel a nice stretch on your hip. And just breathe. Good, and push that knee away. If by pushing doesn't feel quite like you're getting a stretch, you can always scoop onto this leg and pull it in while you're pushing this knee away. I kind of use my elbow to do that. Otherwise, just stay on the mat and use your hands. Push that knee away. And we're gonna switch sides. Ankle over thigh. Grab onto the knee, pull it in towards your chest. Making sure you're breathing. And push this knee away. And again, if you need more of a stretch, you can scoop onto that leg. Otherwise, just stay onto the floor. All right. So we're gonna roll over for some planks here. Now this exercise, I want you to make sure that you're breathing for. That's kind of the biggest key here completely. So what we're gonna do is I want your elbows directly underneath those shoulders. You can tuck your toes underneath you. And now what you're gonna do is you're gonna squeeze your bum muscles, you're gonna pull your belly in, and you're gonna lift your hips up off the mat, not very far, onto your knees and your toes. And you're gonna breathe as we hold. If you feel comfortable, you can come up onto your feet and hold in a nice straight line. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and lower down and rest. Biggest thing is don't hold your breath. Absolutely key. You have to breathe, otherwise it's gonna spike your blood pressure and we don't wanna do that, okay? Again, knees if you feel, or toes, it's up to you. Tuck those toes underneath you, squeeze your bum, pull your belly in, and lift. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good, I'm gonna go up to my toes this time. Feel comfortable to stay on your knees. And lift, keeping your back in line, no sagging bum. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. We're gonna do two more. And lift, make sure you're breathing. One solid line, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and rest. Good job. This time we're gonna do 15 seconds. Okay, here we go. And lift. 15, 14, 13. Make sure your bum's not up, it's down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and done. Good job. We're gonna extend those arms out. We're almost done here. Finish with some Superman. So your head is looking towards the floor. You're gonna lift opposite arm and opposite leg. You're welcome to just do arms or just do legs. That's an option. Otherwise, your opposite arm, opposite leg, you're keeping that back and hips nice and stable and sturdy. If you had a bottle of ice water resting on your low back, you wouldn't want it to spill. So we're keeping everything in line. Three more on each side. Two and one. Good, all the way up to your hands and knees. We'll do a quick stretch. Hands under shoulders, knees under hips. Tuck your tailbone round your spine, let your head drop. And reverse the opposite way, lifting your tailbone up. Your belly sinks, look up. And again, tuck and round. And reverse the opposite way. Good, open your knees out to the edge of the mat. Sit your hips back towards your heels. Your heads come forward, hands come out. And let your head hit towards the floor. If your head doesn't reach the floor, you can stack your fists. Let your head rest in your hands. And just letting those hips sink, let gravity take over. Take a nice deep breath and just relax. I want you to take your right hand and scoop it underneath your left. Rotate your shoulder towards the floor.
Turn your head towards that arm as well, like you're looking underneath your armpit. Good, we're going to come back to center. Left under right. And back to center. Well done. We are all finished. Good job. Let's take a big deep breath. Breathe in. And out. And again. Breathe in. And out. Have a wonderful day. See you again.